वेलकम बैक माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। यू नो इट्स योर सोशल साइंस क्लास एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस आर न्यू चैप्टर ग्रीनलैंड, द लैंड ऑफ आइस एंड स्नो। ग्रीनलैंड इज अ लैंड, इज अ कंट्री हुज नॉर्दर्न पार्ट इज क्लोज टू द नॉर्थ पोल। Do you think plants or animal can live here? Or is it a land of only ice and snow? Okay, so students, by the end of this chapter, you will know the location of Greenland, the climate, vegetation, animal life of Greenland, about Eskimos and their lifestyles, modern developments that have taken place in Greenland. Let me give you introduction of the topic Greenland. Greenland is the largest island in the world, that is not a continent. It means the Greenland is an island, it is not a continent, it is an island and it is the largest island in the world. It is a self-governing province of Denmark. It means it is under political control of Denmark. The capital of Greenland is Nuuk and the earlier name of Nuuk is Qaqortoq. The first European who visited Greenland was Erik the Red and he was an explorer. And he gave the island its name. Climate of the Greenland. The Arctic Circle passes through the southern part of the Greenland, and most of the Greenland therefore lies in frigid zone in the northern hemisphere. Now students, do you remember what is frigid zone? Students, you have already learned about the frigid zones in your previous chapters. The region between the Arctic Circle and North Pole, or between the Antarctic Circle and South Pole, is called the frigid zone. This zone is permanently frozen zone and there is no sunlight for most of the months. It remains cold throughout the year. Students, do you know why it remains cold throughout the year? Yes, it receives very slanting rays of sun, that's why there is very cold throughout the year. Students, the Greenland is located between Arctic Circle and the North Pole. Here you can see the picture of different kinds of zones. On the top we have North Pole and frigid zone, and in between the North Pole and Arctic Circle, we have Greenland. Students, the type of climate found in frigid zones is called polar climate. What do we call the climate that found in frigid zones? Yes, it is called the polar climate, and both the North Pole and South Pole have polar climate. And the North Pole lies in the Arctic Circle, and most of the Greenland lies in Arctic Circle. That's why the Greenland also has a polar type of climate. Look at the screen, students. Here in white color we have Greenland, and near Greenland you can see Baffin Bay and Davis Strait. These places separated from the northern islands of Canada. Look at the picture, students. I have marked circle on Iceland. The Iceland is the nearest European country to Greenland. Okay, the nearest European country to Greenland is Iceland. That is marked here in red color. Students, Greenland lies in the continent of North America, and it is a part of Denmark, and it is the largest island in the world. It is the largest island in the world and its capital is? Do you remember what is the capital of Greenland? Yes, Nuuk is the capital of Greenland. Students, the name Greenland is given by Erik the Red in 981. Erik the Red is an explorer and he gave the name Greenland to this place. Students, the name has no relation with green because Greenland is almost barren and white, and Nuuk is the capital of Greenland. And you can see here in the picture the capital of Greenland, that is Nuuk. Now students, I want to show you the flag and the currency of the Greenland. Here in the picture you can see the flag and the currency of Greenland. Students, sometimes huge pieces of ice break off and slide down into the sea, and these pieces are called icebergs. And about 80% of the area is covered with ice and snow, and the southwestern coast where most of the people live in the warmest part of the Greenland. Sometimes large chunks or sheets of ice get separated and fell down into the sea. And students, the floating mass of ice in the sea is called iceberg. And icebergs are very dangerous for ships especially. And the International Ice Patrol keeps a watch on icebergs. Students, if I tell you to define icebergs, how do you write? Yes, you can write, sometimes huge pieces of ice break off and slide down into the sea, and these pieces are called icebergs. And you can write, huge mass of ice floating in the sea are called icebergs. Students, how much area is covered with ice and snow in Greenland? Yes, 80% of area is covered with ice and snow in Greenland. Icebergs are very dangerous for ships passing through his regions. And students, in 1912, a huge ship called Titanic sank into sea after hitting iceberg. And you know students, it had 1500 passengers, and a famous movie has been made on this accident, and the name of that movie is Titanic. Now it's time to tell you about the climate of the Greenland. And Greenland has a polar climate. It is very cold throughout the year, and the lowest temperature record is minus 66 degrees Celsius in 1954. It means it's very much cold in Greenland. And the climate of Greenland is called polar climate. It is cold throughout the year, and there is a little rainfall. And the temperature is always below 0 degrees Celsius. Most of the time the temperature is below 0 degrees Celsius, and during winter one may not see the sun for several months. There is heavy snowfall also. Students, do you know the Greenland is also called as the land of midnight sun? Do you know why the Greenland is called the land of midnight sun? Yes, in summer the sun shines brightly all the 24 hours in most part of the island, and the sun shines even in midnight. That's why Greenland is called as the land of midnight sun. Clear? Students, in winter there is no sunlight because the sun doesn't rise above the horizon. These are months of darkness. Okay, why the winter is called the months of darkness? Because in winter there is no sunlight in the Greenland. Vegetation in Greenland. There is nothing in Greenland because of its extreme cold climate. But in summers, small grasses and some colorful plants grow in coastal areas. Due to extreme cold, plants growth is not possible in Greenland, and only plants that are found are mosses, lichens, grasses and bushes. There are no forests. If I ask you the question, what kind of plants are found in Greenland, what is the answer? Yes, mosses, lichens, grasses and bushes are plants that are found in Greenland. Animal life in Greenland. Only those animals that can adapt themselves to the extreme cold live here. Reindeer, polar bear, musk ox, Arctic fox, seal and huskies are found here. Reindeer is the most useful animal in Greenland. Fish and seabirds are also found here. Huskies plays important role in the life of people over here. And do you know, students, what are huskies? Yes, huskies are wolf-like dogs. They are used for hunting and for pulling sledges. A sledge is called an ice boat. It has no wheels. Reindeer and seals are the most useful animals here. People of Greenland. The native people of Greenland are called Eskimos, but most of them have now mixed with other Europeans. They are now called Greenlanders or Inuits. Students, do you know how the people of Greenland look alike? Yes, Eskimos are short and stout. They have yellowish skin, high cheekbones and narrow eyes. They lead a very hard life. They wear hooded jackets that are called parkas, and these jackets are made up of the skin of the seal and reindeer. Students, during winter, the Eskimos live in igloos. Igloos are the house made of ice blocks, and modern igloos can be made of wood, stone and skin. During summer, they live in skin tent that are called tupiks. The Eskimos are excellent hunters. They hunt seals, whales and polar bear. In the past, they used bows and harpoons to hunt animals. What do the Eskimos hunt? Yes, they hunt seals, whales and polar bear. And next question, in the past, what things they used to hunt animals? Yes, in the past, the Eskimos used bows and harpoons to hunt animals. Students, the Eskimos are very intelligent and they make use of almost every part of the hunting animals. They use its flesh as food and use its fat as fuel to cook food. The bones and tendons are used to make needles and harpoons head. In the past, sledges were the main means of transport in Greenland. They were pulled by either strong dogs called huskies or reindeers. And it means, students, if I ask you the question, what are the main means of transport in Greenland in past? And the answer is, sledges were the main means of transport in Greenland in past. Small boats called kayaks and big boats called umiaks. Modern times in Greenland. The life of Eskimos has undergone many changes in recent times, and now Greenland cities have air links with Europe and America. Eskimos today use motorized sledges called skidoos for transport. They use motor boats for fishing. Nowadays, there are good roads and a fine network of communication. School, colleges and hospitals have been opened. Some towns have air links with Denmark and North America. This has brought them closer to the rest of the world. And now, students, now they use rifles and guns in place of harpoons for hunting. There is compulsory and free education for children up to the age of 14. That's why there are so many schools, colleges and hospitals in Greenland. I hope you all understood the chapter. Let's do some exercises. Define the following. Number one, iceberg. Huge mass of ice floating in the sea is called iceberg. Parka. What is parka? Jacket with a hood to cover the head. Next, tupik. A tent made of animal skin is called tupik. And umiak is a broad boat that can carry many people. Means big boat is called umiak. Next, blubber. Blubber means fat of animals like whale and seal. And Eskimos use this blubber as a fuel. Next, harpoons. Harpoons is a spear with a long rope attached to it. Kayak. A narrow boat that is moved with a single paddle, flat at both end, is called kayak. Next word is igloo. Igloo means a house made of snow or ice. Means a house made of snow or ice is called igloo. Next exercise, fill in the blanks. Number one, the capital of Greenland is Dash, earlier called Dash. And the answer is, the capital of Greenland is Nuuk, earlier called Gothab. Next, the frigid zone in which most of Greenland is situated is also called tundra region. What is the answer? Tundra. The frigid zone in which most of Greenland is situated is also called tundra region. Next, huge pieces of ice floating in the sea are known as dash. Do you know the answer? What is the answer of this fill in the blank? Yes, icebergs. Huge pieces of ice floating in the sea are known as icebergs. Next, the original inhabitants of Greenland are Dash, also called Dash. And the answer is Inuits and Eskimos. So, you can write the original inhabitants of Greenland are Inuits and also called Eskimos. Next, Dash are temporary house made of blocks of ice by the Inuit. And the answer is igloos. Igloos are temporary houses made of blocks of ice by the Inuits. Next exercise, tick the correct answers. Here, after question, I will give you three options and you have to choose the right one. So, the first one is, the dogs which help the Eskimos are called. Options are huskies, dholes, hunters. And I hope you all know the answer, that is huskies. Next, the native people of Greenland are called Bedouins, Eskimos, Bhils. What is the answer? I hope you all know the answer. That is Eskimos. Next, number 3. Greenland lies in the dash. Here we have different options: temperate zone, torrid zone, freezer zone. And the answer is, where the Greenland lies? Yes, Greenland lies in the frigid zone. Next, number 4. The capital of Greenland is dash. And the options are Iceland, Nuuk, Norway. And I hope you all know the answer. And the answer is Nuuk. Students, I hope you all understood the chapter, and now you are able to do all the exercises. Thank you so much for joining the class.